You thought Windows Calculator was not enough. Well, how about Windows 7 Genius Edition 2010? Straight into the installation. Well, the tech setup? So, this is based on Windows XP, huh? I hope the graphical setup isn't gonna torture me or something. So, the second phase of the setup is filled with mess and mess. Starting with spelling mistakes, improper grammar, and several claims such as full activated and full support for the latest games and graphics. Which can't be true, right? Ah, goddammit! The power went out! Seriously? In the middle of the video? Oh my goodness, this is so bad. Do I really have to get this all over again? Oh, finally, the power is back on. Aside from more additional programs allegedly installed on this bootleg and some more claims, for some reason, the setup starts to ask questions about Egypt, like, what do you know about Egypt? Well, pyramids, the Nile River, the Pharaoh, and what? I don't know anything else than that. Oh, really? Really? You put a whole paragraph of Arabic text about the ancient Egyptian civilization? Is anyone really gonna read it? Lam takun hadara? That means, they haven't? Oh my god!
Later.
Oh, finally! It reboots! Oh, that's very cool, not gonna lie about it. As per usual, the OOB is just really goofy. No further comment. The heck is that log on screen? Longhorn log on screen? This has nothing to do with Windows 7 at all! Oh yeah, I haven't clicked that subscribe button yet. Oh yeah, there it is. And so do most of you, so click that subscribe button so that I can reach 6,000 subscribers by mid-November. No pressure. Now, we are at the post-install script. Okay, I'ma select them all. Wait, where's the next button? That is so crazy! Oi, oi mate! Why is the mouse moving by itself? Oh, it's doing it again! Ah, for the love of goodness, the power went out again? Seriously, it's twice! No! Please don't! This time. Alright. Power is going on again, and I hope that the power isn't gonna be, like, off for the next, I don't know, like, 10 minutes. Oh, the setup is finished. Alright, rebooting the OS and we're booting into the desktop. Looking at the desktop, aside from the beautiful landscape as the desktop background, you can see that the icons in this bootleg are changed to somewhat using Windows 7 icons. Because this bootleg is actually trying to mimic Windows 7. But you'll see why it's sort of failed. The taskbar is done okay for Windows XP, but it can be better. By clicking the start button, and it's executed badly. The icons are too big, the right side of the start menu is not resembling Windows XP's layout, nor Windows 7's layout. I'm confused, and don't get me started on the old programs list. Yeah, simply it's just Windows XP's version with Windows 7 icons and stuff. Taking a look at File Explorer and I honestly don't even know how to call this a resemblance. The side panel is just XP's with the background change. The My Computer layout is not even from Windows 7. The Organize button, which is supposed to show more options, is just a switch for Tree View. Oh, and also the Preview Pane button doesn't work as expected. Speaking of additional themes and visual styles, the Genius Team generously adds one screensaver. Yes, just one. On the other side, the Genius Team adds six visual styles to this bootleg. My gosh, I wonder what ugliness does these themes offer. Clear XP is, well, a Glass X theme with Windows XP layout. Understandable. Diamond, which came pre-bundled with window blinds. White Clear, which is just another glass thing, but with more white visible on its glass. I don't know what to explain about this. White Flame, another Vista theme, I guess. Oh my... Gosh, there's something off with one of the themes. The icons got swollen by the recent program list. Oh my goodness. Oh wait, there's more. Oh yeah, in Clear XP. Look at the control panel. You can just use Photoshop to remove the background, but no, they don't. They don't give a single crap and just plaster the image right to the theme. Enough of that, let's look at the wallpapers that came with this bootleg. Most of them are just landscapes, but some of them don't make any sense, like this Iron Man image and another one here. It's not like there's Microsoft Windows Avengers Edition. Since this is... Is it necessary to put that banner on run dialogue? Is it that necessary? Since this bootleg is based on Windows XP Service Pack 3 by looking at the version string. So basically, like many of other bootleg based on either Windows 7 or Windows XP, there are so many programs that comes with this bootleg that I agree to install, such as AIMP, a very old version of Mozilla Firefox, a discontinued version of Opera, TuneUp Utilities, Yahoo Messenger, CCleaner, Foxit Reader, Internet Download Manager, Media Player Classic, Raymeter, which helps bring the Windows 7 gadgets into this bootleg, and Ultra ISO. That's all I can see in the desktop, and maybe all of them that are significant.
I don't know, man.
This bootleg is already pretty goofy, but I hope there aren't bootlegs worse than this, please. This is just about okay for me, because other than those changes, this bootleg is just a badly executed Windows XP bootleg. I mean, come on, really? Like, is anyone really buying this and using this? Maybe, well, one person or two with 69 IQ or something. This bootleg again comes from the Cross Windows Wiki as well as its server, which you can join. The link will be in the description of this video. I hope this bootleg is just the limit of my craziness. If you have even crazy bootlegs that you want to see, then you can tell me in the comments or message me on my Discord server. Of course, the download link will be in the description of this video. Thank you Cross Windows for providing the ISO. If you want to relieve your Windows 11 because you can fix it by checking out this video. Meanwhile, like and share this video. Thank you to my supporter for making this video possible. And also don't forget to check out this video.